doing?
She's doing pretty good.
No, when is the baby?
It's here.
Oh, I didn't know the baby.
10 days old.
What did she have?
A boy.
What did she name?
Henry Holden Wilder von Paul.
Oh, what a handle to put on a little guy.
I said, when he gets in school, he'll hate
it. Yeah, he sure will.
Thank you. Well, I don't know what you came to do.
I came to praise the Lord.
I don't know what
you came to do, but I came to praise the Lord.
I don't know what still God. It don't matter what's going on, God's still God, and He's still in control of all things. And I don't know about you, I am more than blessed. Would you sing with me? Well, I am blessed.
Bye.
Square in the eye and say, you know what? I just want you to know I'm glad you're in the house of the Lord with me, if you would. God bless you.
Good evening, everyone. We've got a couple announcements. The Paoli tubing trip's been canceled. There just wasn't enough interest in it, and they're going to schedule a movie night. There'll be more information on that to follow, but they'll have a movie night that night. Stitchers of Grace is going to meet Tuesday at 9 a.m. Believe it or not, that's all the announcements I have tonight. If we could have our ushers come forward, we'll take up our evening offering. Brother Ed, lead us in prayer.
Brother, Father, we come before you again this morning. We thank you for this day. Thank you for another opportunity to have a meeting with our Savior. Pray that you will bless everything that's said and done in tonight's service. Be with the pastor. Bring us forth from that. Help him to preach what you have in the heart. Help us to have a heart and open mind to listen to you. Pray that you will bless us for our service.
Amen. Go right on, fellas.
I love you, Lord.
for your faithfulness and giving tonight. Brother Wayne, don't sit down. Over here and sing for us.
It's the tape on the low side.
Of God, I'll win a shining crown.
Someday we'll all keep holding on to that nail-scarred hand. And I'm not giving up, no, I'll keep going on. I've been walking through the valley, through this veil of tears. At times I've even questioned, even if my Lord was near. Many times that old tempter says, why not turn around? You can't get any farther because you're just losing ground. Oh, but I'm not giving up. No, I'm not turning around. And by the grace of God, I'll win a shining crown. Someday will I'll keep holding on to that nail-scarred hand. And I'm not giving up, no, I'll keep going on. And would you mind to tell me there's been something bothering me? Won't let God's children be. You see, he has purpose and determined to get right in the way and turn us from the way of life and lead our souls astray. Well, but I'm not giving up. No, I'm not turning around. And by the grace of I'm not giving up, no, I'll keep going on. Well, I'm not giving up, no, I'm not turning around. And by the grace of God, I'll win a shining crown. Someday, well, I'll keep holding on to that nail-scarred hand. I'm not giving up, no, I'll keep going, giving up, no, I'm not turning round, and by the grace of God, I'll win a shining crown, someday, well, I'll keep holding on to that nail-scarred hand. I'm not giving up. I'll keep going on.
Thank you, Heaven. Can't give up. My Bible tells me that those that endure till the end shall be saved. Sister Sheila.
Jesus, should I fall down? Let me land.
Dana, you ready? Come on. Paula, are you going to sing with her?
Give her a heart attack. She's getting so she don't want to sing with me, and I don't know why. So I didn't give her a chance tonight. I just told her we were singing. You know, I love the Lord, and I thank Him for everything He's done for me, and I wouldn't want to face the day without Him. You know, I know that a lot of people, when you talk to people, they're facing storms in their life, and you know, the thing they have to do is hold on to the Lord, because the storm will pass and God will bring them through. And we're going to sing one of Sister B's old ones, "Till the Storm Passes By."
In the dark of the midnight, have I oft hid my face while the storm of the
trials of life, he can hold us in the palm of his hand. That's the God we're serving, folks. He can hold you in the palm of his hand and keep his hand upon you. Praise his name. Sammy, you ready? Come up here and sing for us.
We do serve an awesome God tonight, don't we, folks? Amen. Many times in life I feel like I messed up so bad that I couldn't get back up. You ever been there? God, I did it this time. You ever said that? I have.
Know that I'm unworthy, Lord, to call upon your name. All my life I've been a sinner, and for that I am ashamed. But I heard that you would listen, so I'm giving. There are others who can offer more than I, but I promise you I understand if for me you had no time, and I think I've just hit bottom and I'm looking up. From the seeds that I have sown, Lord, you only touch him. We haven't spoken for so long. If you could spare some mercy, Lord, I pledge my life. God would give him a son. Blessed I was his name, the greatest gift he had ever known. Then came the day, who would have dreamed that God would say,
your heart out of this world and you set it on Jesus. Amen. Is that right? Can I get an amen?
Amen.
I would find myself out of a lot of trouble. I wouldn't have gotten half the trouble in my life I'd have got in if I just had my eyes on God instead of on man or on the world. Amen.
Amen.
Can I get an amen tonight, folks? That's the truth. That's the truth tonight. Listen, we have to step outside of our comfort zone sometimes. In the middle of the day, maybe it's at Walmart, you never know. And just stand there for a second and say, God, thank you for letting me get to Walmart in that nice vehicle I just drove in. I don't care if it's got 398,000 miles on it. It got me here and in one piece, and I thank you for that. God, listen, it just hit me. What would happen in the church world if somebody asked for prayer in the middle of a grocery store? Would you do it?
Oh, yeah.
Now, you say yes. You say yes, but at the time when there's a busy right in the middle of the day, 5 o'clock at Walmart on Friday. Think, imagine that. Would you have a problem laying hands on somebody right in the middle of Walmart? Glory to God. Sometimes we got to do that, folks, to step outside our comfort zone just to stay in the mindset that God wants us to be in. Because that one person might need you in the middle of, hey, it happened to me one time. I always said, I'll pray for anybody anywhere. I will pray for anybody anywhere, and I got Walmart one night. I was in a hurry. I was rushing. I'm just like Brent when I go to Walmart. I know exactly what I need, exactly where it's at. I go in to get it, then I get out of there. I don't like it. So I was on my little way, and I was beelining to where I needed to go, and all of a sudden this sister went, "Hey, Brother Sam, oh, hi, sis, how you doing?" And God said, "You need to stop, go back, talk to her." And I was like, "Oh, okay." So I, okay. So I turned around, and I went and talked to, "Hey, sister, how you doing?" "Sam, I'm not doing good. I need some prayer." "All right, I'll be praying with you." "No, I need prayer right now. I mean, like, it just, something just hit me. I just found out about this. Now, I need prayer in the middle of Walmart." And I'm like, "Oh, Jesus, am I ready for this? Am I ready to step outside my cabin?" Listen, it's different whenever there's a bunch of sinner folks around you not knowing what on earth you're doing. Right? And this lady was spiritual. She didn't care to let them tears flow and them hands go up. So we did, right in the middle of Walmart. "God, I thank you for this, another day of life, and I praise you for all that you do for me. God, I thank you for my sister right here that's going through this struggle. God, you know what the needs are in her life. You know what the needs are in her heart, God, even things that I don't know. God, right now, in the name of your son, Jesus, who you sent to this earth just for us, I'm asking you, Father, to help this woman right now. Right now, Lord, in the name of your son, Lord, come down and touch in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah, hallelujah." And all of a sudden I felt his spirit and his presence take over. And I couldn't help myself but to start and to get a little excited right there in the middle of Walmart. Folks, we got to be ready in instant, in season and out of season. We got to be ready for that struggling brother or sister that's out there. Wednesdays and Sundays are fantastic, but what about the other 5 days of the week? Whenever that lost brother or sister needs you, or that 2 o'clock in the morning when they need you, will you be ready? Hallelujah. I'm going to shut up. God is good. All the time. Folks, be ready. In the twinkling of an eye, he's going to come down. It's going to be so quick, we ain't going to recognize it. I believe the inner me will know it before the flesh me does. I'm that slow. It's going to take me. What's going on? Oh, here we go. But it's going to happen so fast, we ain't even going to have time. Lord, if I've got anything in here that I did yesterday, would you please forgive me? And it's going to be too late. Because you've had time and time again. Listen to me, folks. Somebody here needs to hear time and time again. God has given you the opportunity to get things straightened up in your life. Listen. Hey, listen up. Time and time again, God has given you time and time again to get stuff straightened up in your life. And this is a warning. If you know who you are, and when that time comes, and you're not ready, it's going to be nobody else's fault but yours.
Right.
Own up to your own salvation tonight. Own up to yourself. Mommy and Daddy can't do it for you. Brother and sister can't do it for you. Pastor Brent can't do it for you. I can't do it for you. It's between you and it's between God. And I need you to know that tonight. Because the opportunity is yours. That relationship is yours. And it's time to get ready and stop playing around. It's time to get ready and put all of yourself into this relationship with God. Amen. It's time to get ready and stop fooling around. And on every other day of the week, you're out here sinning. And then you come to church and act like everything's okay. Are you hearing me tonight? Are you hearing me tonight? Brother Ben, is this okay? Listen, folks. Time is running out. Time's running out. And it's up to you. Brent preaches his heart out every single Sunday and every single Wednesday. But it's up to you. I preach my heart out every single Wednesday and we teach every single Sunday. But it is up to you. What you do outside of these walls is up to you. Ultimately, you decide what comes out of your mouth. You decide what goes in. And what goes in. And what goes in. It is up to you. Make no mistake that if you need something from God, he's going to be there 100% of the time.
Right.
Here's how relationships work. And I found this out the hard way. When I was getting ready to get married, people always told me, "Paula," said, "it's 50-50. And I took it as that. It's 50-50. And I got into my marriage and I found out that that was wrong. It is not 50-50. If you ain't giving 100% of yourself 100% of the time, you are not in a relationship. And that's the same way with God. God don't want you lukewarm.
That's
He don't want you straddling the fence. God don't want, he would rather see you hot or cold rather than be lukewarm, or he will spew you. That's violently, by the way. Out. Because he can't stand it. But it's time to just man or woman up. Because there is consequence for every action that we take in this life, for every decision that we make in this life, that there's consequence. You'll find it all through the Bible. Almost on every page. Come on. Pharisees found a lot of consequence when coming around Jesus. Come on. David had consequence for every action that he took, whether it be good or bad. Elijah. You name anybody in the Bible, and we went over a lesson the other night, folks, and I'm getting ready to sit down. We went over a lesson the other night, but it's up to you, and youth group, it's up to you to make that step. It's up to you. Listen, nobody can have your relationship with God for you.
Right, that's it. Amen. Come on.
Dad, you can't have your relationship with God for me.
No.
Jacob, I love you, but I can't have your relationship with God for you. My little boy turned 6. He gave his heart to God when he was 5. Right here at this altar. People said that's too young, but he knew. He came up and I said, son, do you know what this means? Yes, I do, Daddy. Do you know what's getting ready to happen? Yes, I do, Daddy. I know that Jesus is real. I know that God is real. I know that there is sin in this world. And I know that if I do this, that I can make heaven my home one day through Jesus. He knows that. And I did too, because I was the exact same age. Come on. Sure, yeah, let's do it. But it is up to you. Are you ready? And we're going to sing this song real quick. Then I'm going to shut up maybe and get out of the way. I'm going to shut up maybe and get out of the way. Because if God tells me to do something, folks, I got to do it. I'd rather be beat by man than be whipped by God. I'm telling you that right now. Because I've had it both ways. I've had it both ways. You've been walking the same old road for miles and miles. If you've been hearing the same old voice tell the same old lies. If you're trying to feel the same old holes inside, there's a better life. There's a better life. We've all found ourselves worn out from the same old life. And we've all run to things we know just ain't right. And there's a better life. Did you know that? There's a better life. If you got faith, he's a pain taker. If you feel lost, he's a way maker. If you need freedom, got chains, he's a chain pray. Folks, there's somebody here needs to pray, I'm telling you. If you need to pray, run. Don't give the devil the time to fight with your head. Run to the altar. Come on. If you need freedom for saving, he's a prison shaking savior. If you got chains, he's a chain breaker. And we've all searched for the light of day in the dead of night. And we've all found ourselves worn out from the same old fight. And we've all run to things we know just ain't right. There's a better life. There's a better life. If you got pain, he's a pain taker. If you feel alone, for saving, he's a prison shaking savior. If you got chains, chain, praise her. Come on, folks, come pray for the kids.
Let me walk.
Well, I'm learning to lean. I'm learning to lean. I'm learning to lean on Jesus. I need more power than I ever dreamed. I'm learning to
because he
my future and life is worth the living just because he lives.
I want to read you a scripture tonight. Go ahead and play softly if you would. God is a faithful God. The Bible tells us that he's a friend who sticks closer than a brother. And he said, I'll never leave you, I'll never forsake you. But I think most Christians need to understand something. You have a right to come to the Lord. And you have a right to pray when you have a need. You have a right to pray when something's not going the way it should be going. Hebrews, the 10th chapter. And I love this scripture. In the 19th verse, it says this: having therefore boldness to enter into the holiest by the blood of Jesus, by a new and living way, which he hath consecrated for us through the veil, that is to say, his flesh. And I love this: and having a high priest over the house of God. Listen to what the word says here real quickly. Let us draw near with a true heart, in full assurance of faith, having our hearts sprinkled from an evil conscience and our bodies washed with pure water. Let us hold fast profession of our faith without wavering, for he is faithful that promised. Sometimes when things are going in our life and we know that maybe we haven't done everything we should be doing, we've not prayed as much as we should, we've not read our Bible as much as we should have read our Bible, maybe we've not gone to church as much as we should have went to church, but I want you to know that God is a gracious and a merciful God. Amen. And as a child of God, we have the right tonight to come boldly. There's a difference between being bold and being cocky. Boldness with a pure heart, in full assurance of faith. How many believes that God can still do anything tonight? Let me tell you what, when the Lord ministered these scriptures to me, had no idea how the service was going to go tonight, never do. I just know that God ministers, and when he ministers, you have to do with what he says. Child of God, it's time to boldly enter into the presence of God. I got a message today, Brother Larry, from the young man that came up here this morning and knelt down and prayed. And he sent me a message this afternoon, or it was early afternoon. He said, you know, I was coming to my... He called it his sister's church. He said, I've been going to my sister's church. And he said, every time you preach, he said, in essence, I'm going to put this in my words, you're hitting me right between the eyes with everything that you're preaching. And he said, this morning, after I got done, he said, it was no longer my sister's church. It became my church. Now, let me tell you something to you this morning, this evening, if I can. There's a lot of people in this old world that's made a lot of mistakes. They've done a lot of things, and you know what? They're paying the consequences for it. But as a child of God, it's up to us to show them that way, that truth, and that life. It blessed my heart when he sent that to me. He said, I want to do whatever I can do. And I said, you know what? That's awesome. And I love hearing these kind of things. But folks, that's just one. There are thousands more in this community that need to be reached by the Master. And let me ask you, how many of you are willing to boldly go to the throne of grace and begin to bombard the portals of heaven for this church and for those that are lost in this community? Let me tell you what, there's a lot of churches, and a lot of churches doing a lot of good things, but there's a lot of churches that aren't. And I want you to know, I don't want anybody looking down their nose and saying, you know what, that church down there don't care, because I'm going to tell you, we care. We care that people aren't saved. We care that people don't know what to do and don't know where to turn. And this song, Because He Lives, I Can Face Tomorrow. I can, because I'm a Christian. But how many people tonight have given up and they have no hope? And in their life, they said there's nothing worth living for. I want you to sing this chorus with me, if you would. And I want you to shut your eyes for a few moments. And I want you just to lift up your voice and your hands to heaven. And I want you to just begin to worship Him. And because He lives, would you reach out to Him tonight? I can face tomorrow. Just sing it one more time. Because He lives, and because He lives, I can face tomorrow. Because He lives, just because He still lives, all fear is gone. And because I know He holds my future, my life is worth the living just because He lives. God is faithful. That when we pray, He hears our prayers. Can I say something to you here real quickly? I don't care how long you've been in church. I don't care what you've done wrong. If you got to come back, you got to come back. If you got to make it right, you got to make it right. I'm going to tell you, I'm just going to be just as blunt as I can. We need to quit worrying about what everybody else is thinking and start getting serious about serving God. Can I get an amen? Amen. We need to quit worrying. Well, somebody's going to think that I'm done. Who cares what people think? I'll be honest with you. They're probably thinking stuff about you anyway. I heard a preacher say something the other day, and I want to share this with you. He said, everybody's always talking about the old days. And he said something I had never thought about, but it was this. He said, if you really get to thinking about it, the old days were just as hard as today is. And things weren't always great even in the old days. But there's a big difference between the old days and today. In the old days, people had a firm foundation and an absolute trust and faith in God. In the day we're living right now, there's too many people that are wavering in their faith. And I want you to know right now, it's time to get serious with God. Can I get an amen? I don't know about you. I don't want anything separating me from God. I don't want anything getting between me and Him. And I love tonight the opportunity to be able to tell you, you have the right to boldly come into the presence of God. And I don't care how small or how big you think it is, God cares about everything in your life. Let me tell you what, I'm a dad, and I care what's going on in my kid's life. And I guarantee you, our Heavenly Father cares what's going on in your life right now. You just got to let the Lord work and let Him minister in your life. I can tell you right now from experience, there's nothing worth laying down your faith for. There's nothing worth giving up for. There was a time in my life I would have walked right out because I thought that's what I had to do. But I'm telling you what, I'm glad God didn't give up on me. And God held on with everything He could until I knew that I knew that I knew I needed the Lord. I don't know about you. What a wonderful day we've had. My goodness. What a wonderful service this morning. Good spirit tonight. And I don't know about you. I'm just glad I'm saved. I'm glad I'm born again. And I want you tonight to make a concerted effort to pray more than you've ever prayed. To seek God more than you've ever sought God. And when you come to into His presence, come in there boldly. With full assurance of faith. Let's see more people saved like this morning. Someone give their heart back to the Lord tonight. So thank God for that too. Amen. You see, God knows what He's doing. And He knows how to do it. And I don't know about you. Before we walk out of this church, aren't you glad He still lives? And let's sing one more time. Well, because He lives, I can face tomorrow, because He lives, all fear is gone, and because I know He holds my I don't know about you, but I'm glad I came to church tonight. Let me encourage you, folks. Let's do all we can do for Him and let Him do all He wants to do for us. Can I get an amen for that tonight? Amen. We're going to let you get out of here if you want to tonight. Don't forget, a few things going on, not a lot. January is usually our slow month, but we had a plan of meeting tonight. Enjoy it. Because after January, it all gets busy again. And I got a lot of things going to happen this year, and we're excited about all the things that are getting ready to happen. And we want you to get involved in everything you can. Folks, look around and see folks that aren't here. I call, but you know what? Sometimes it does a whole lot of good when somebody else notices somebody's not here and calls them and says, you know what? We're just glad. We just want you to know we miss you, and we want to see you back in church. Amen. Thank you so much for being here tonight. Say the Lord richly bless you. Yes. Okay, the little great grandbaby's back home. Good. Good. Well, ain't nothing wrong with that kid. And thank God. God answers prayer, folks. I'm telling you, if they took him to the hospital, he wasn't doing good. And bring him back home and can't find nothing, I think God ought to be praised for that. How about you tonight? Amen. God is faithful. Don't forget, Wednesday night, we have church around here. 7 o'clock, come on out, and let's let God have His way. Continue to pray one for another. Continue to pray for your church. And if you don't have nothing else to pray for me, because I'll take all the prayers you got. Amen. God bless you tonight. Shake hands with one another. Let them know what you love them. And hope to see everybody Wednesday night. God bless.